Welcome, it's really awesome to be here. I actually always love speaking at university. It's kind of this creepy feeling inside you. I know you haven't been at the university studying yet, but if you do, it's always this, you know, you walk into these big buildings and it's always this crazy feeling to be, at least at the old university buildings, you walk into a building that's over 500 years old and I don't know, hundreds of thousands of people have studied before you, so it's always a great honor to speak on academic grounds. So thanks to you guys to let me speak here, and a big welcome to all of you. As Jose mentioned, it's my second talk at Fear and Fail, and I really love it because it's kind of this moment where you get naked in front of, I don't know, 200, 300 people, and that's always a strange feeling, but in the end, I always like it. It's always this kick where you go to sleep at night and think, wow, today was really cool. So welcome. My topic today is a little bit about history, and it's all about living in Austria, in a country where 60, 70 years ago, a lot of bad things happened, and the whole generation after World War II grew up with this thing in mind, which told them, don't do any risk, you know? We lost everything, we lost a lot, and now we're starting building up again everything. And this included doing no risk, you know? Building stone after stone, getting some education, and my grandparents passed it on to my parents. And my parents and my grandparents always told me, go to school, look for a great job, for a secure job, and do it as long as you can. So don't risk a lot, do a good education, and you will be safe in the end. But that probably worked 50 years ago or 40 years ago. It probably worked a little bit when I was your age, but it most definitely worked yet for you guys. And that's one of the key topics I would like to speak with you today. And it's really crazy because when I grew up, you see, my first job was being a Pampers model. So that was kind of the first job my parents introduced me to. My father always took photos of me and sent it to companies like this Pampers one and tried to raise some money for my college fund and everything. So that was kind of fun, even though I don't remember, it's a little bit embarrassing. And then my parents always told me, you know, go to school, have fun there, try to be a good student, that you can go to university. And this kind of thought really was stuck into my mind, and you can see it. I even got Harvard sweatshirts. I don't know, I'm probably 6 years old with my little sister there. and I got this Harvard sweatshirt. So when I grew up, all the time somebody was asking me what I would like to do. I always said, I want to be a student. So that was kind of really funny because everybody in my environment always told me, you know, get good education, go to university, then you will have a good job, and so on and so forth. And it was really inside of me. And that was kind of really interesting. And my parents, they gave up everything. My mother was working. I think she didn't buy some new clothes for 10 years for herself, just to have enough money to send me to a private school. Because they knew, just if you go to a private school here in Austria, you get high-end, top-level education, so you can go to really good universities, and then having really good education. So that was kind of really interesting. And when I was your age right now, we had a junior company. So it's 15 years ago or so. Probably you can now see me there. That's my mini-me when I was at your age. And that was the first time when I experienced being an entrepreneur, like you all are doing right now. It was the first time when I did something I believed in. It was really the first time, and it was a really, really great feeling. Probably you are experiencing it right now. Yeah? So that was kind of this moment where I said, cool. And what we were doing back then was, we were helping young students. I was going to HTL Innsbruck. Probably some Tirolians are here today, I hope so. Yes, cool guys. Yes, I. So we as older students help younger ones when they come to HTL and had some problems with learning. We did a social buddy system, helped them learning, and it was a really good feeling. Not by just helping somebody, but learning a lot by ourselves. And I was really passionate about it. We did it like 1.5 years after our junior company ended, and we really had this idea to found a company after graduating from HTL, from high school. But we never did it. And I deeply believe one reason was that everybody told us and all our friends that we should go to college or start somewhere to work and develop our career, because it's very important to have a job for a long time, then you earn more money, and when you earn more money, it's more safe and you don't have to take any risks. So that was kind of this moment where I experienced the first time in my life something completely different. And after graduating from high school, I started studying, you know, guess what? Then it was really hard to answer what I would like to accomplish in my life, and somebody asked, because I was a student. So this completely new time came where I was asking myself, okay, now I'm at university, now I'm doing what I always wished for, what comes after university? So it was also this very strange moment. I had the opportunity to study in the United States for 1 year, which was a really cool opportunity. And to see how other education systems work, to see how, for example, a bachelor's degree in America is something like matura here. So that was also some experience, because I took some bachelor classes at the university in America, and they learned English, they learned history at university, because the high schools before don't get everybody on the same level. So at university, they had to get everybody on the same page, and in the fourth or sixth semester, you learn studying chemistry or whatever you enrolled for. So it was also very interesting to see how it's here in Austria and in other countries. And after my studies, I moved here to Vienna, and I'm living here in Vienna since 5 years. And in these 5 years, I did a lot of jobs. First of all, I went into marketing, and then I got hired by a big online agency, the biggest here in Austria. And afterwards, I got hired by a software development company from Linz to build up their office here in Vienna. And it was kind of this experience where you go up this ladder and you think, wow, I'm right on track. You know, everybody was saying to me from my family, wow, you finally got a job. You're a branch manager, you're the CEO of a software development company here in Vienna. And everybody thought, wow, that's it, you know, now we're safe. But for me, it wasn't the same. You know, I did everything that everybody thought that's good, but for me, I reached this moment where I was standing right at the end and said, wow, is that what life is for me? Is this job really what I would love to do for the next 10 years? And I would like to ask you this question. If you think, okay, what would you like to do next? Is this really the thing you would love to do for your whole life? Because that's something really crazy going on also at school right now. That we are in a school system and at schools that were built up 100, 150 years ago and haven't changed a lot, when we're honest. And if I, looking 5 years ahead, and ask myself what will be in 5 years, I have no clue. I have no idea what will happen in 5 years. But people at school are telling you what you learn right now will give you a safe job in 20 years, in 30 years. Yeah? And if you calculate a little bit, you are now 18, 19, or 20. What will be the year when you retire? When you hit pension? Yeah? It will be 2060. Yeah? Probably 2070, 2080. Yeah? What will happen then? How will the world change? You know? And so that's something what I learned, that until I had university, I always thought, okay, what I learned at school, that's it, you know. But in the end, what you're doing right now, doing something on your own, accomplish something new, think outside the box, those are the skills you need in life, okay? So that's very important. That was also a very important experience on my own. And I'm from Taiwan, so there always have to be a mountain in the presentation. So when I was hitting this end of the road and I had these feelings that I have to change something, I went on this hiking. You know, I went outside and thought, what can I do? What can I do different? What else is out there in life? And I rediscovered my entrepreneurial project back at school. And I had this crazy night when I was coming home. My wife Doris, she's here today, she probably remember. I was at this conference and I had this very inspiring talk, and I came home and couldn't sleep. I tried to sleep, but there was no way. And I found this old concept, this junior company concept we did right back in school. And I was reading through it and I thought, man, that was really cool what we were doing back there. You know, after studying, after working for a couple of years, I read this paper I was writing when I was 10 years younger, and it was really cool. I was really surprised by myself that I was able to write something 10 years before, okay? So I asked myself, why did I study? Why did I work 5 years when I already had those cool ideas 10 years ago? So that was really strange, and I was up all night, I read this old concept, and I was writing a new one. But 50% or 60% was just copy and paste from the things I did right back at school. I mean, there were some things I worked on, I knew a little better, but basically it was the same concept. And that was really, really, really awesome. It was a great experience for me. And it was this moment of craziness, you know, where you came home, you're really tired, probably you had a couple of beers or so, and you can't sleep. And you just, ideas are spreading out of your mouth, out of your head, and I was writing a whole little book full of ideas what I can do in my future, okay? And when I hit this crazy moment, I thought, okay, now I'm moving on. Now I'm doing something I like, I'm passionate about. And that's also something I ask all of you today, and when you think about your future, find something you're passionate about. Find something you like. Not what everybody else is telling you what you should like. Find something you like. Probably it's something that you're doing right now at your junior company. Probably not. Okay, so always think about what you love, because I experienced when you do something what you love, you're really good at it. And if you're doing something, you can do also a good job, but it's not great. You're only great if you do something you really love. And it sounds very easy, right? You know, probably you heard it for 10 times, but I experienced it and it's totally true. And it also brings you probably, who is doing Matrix, Matrix? It was my first DVD. Matrix was my first DVD I've ever bought. It was probably 15 years ago. So when I was your age, it was when VHS was considered old and DVD was coming up, so it's not that long ago, but I feel very old now. And in Matrix, there was this funny decision moment, okay, where he is sitting in the chair and saying, okay, do you want to take the blue pill or do you want to take the red pill? And the blue pill was going outside the Matrix and discover what the real world is all about. And I was feeling kind of the same. I remember the day when I bought this DVD and I was really happy and watching the movie, and I was at the same moment. Should I keep working at my job or should I do something I'm really passionate about? And I said, man, you know, back then I was 29 or 28, and I said, okay, I'm young, I feel good, I want to do something I love, and I took the blue pill. And since then, I had the greatest time ever. It was so cool to do something I would like to do. We founded our own company. We were doing the same we were doing at the junior company. Now we're building Talentify Me, which is an online platform that should help you guys attending cool workshops outside of school to learn something you want, to help other students if you're good in math, in German, tutor, Nachhilfe geben for kids that are not so fortunate as you are, that they don't have the opportunity to found their own junior company at school. There are a lot of kids in Austria with basically no chance in life, no perspective, just because they were born in a family from lower socioeconomic background, and that's very unfair. And you are in this cool position where you can really help and tell others about it. And since I was attending this roller coaster of being an entrepreneur, that was also a very fun experience, because at some point you wake up and think, what am I doing here? Do I even have enough money to buy something to eat in 2 months? Yeah? Am I totally crazy being an entrepreneur, risking everything? And on the other hand, this roller coaster is going up again, and you see that what you're doing really impacts something, really helps somebody. And you talk to parents or to students like you, and you get really good feedback. And this really brings you up this roller coaster, and it's a really great feeling. And then it's going down again, and probably in the time frame of 5 minutes, okay? So this state of, oh wow, that's really cool what I'm doing, to, whoa, should I really do this? Can happen in 5 minutes, you know? But it's really awesome to do this roller coaster. Who was on a roller coaster here already? Isn't it a cool feeling to go up and down again and have this crazy feeling in your stomach, okay? remember this feeling, because that's how it is being an entrepreneur every day. And that's really awesome at some point. Yeah, and one of the last things I would like to remind you is that actually it's not that risky to kind of being an entrepreneur, to try do something on your own, because you're very fortunate if you live in Austria or here in the Western world. Because, for example, here in Austria, if you want to found your own company, there is a whole social security layer that supports you. For example, I was working before, and there is a really cool program from INS. It's called Unternehmensgründungsprogramm, which gives you 6 months of time. You get money from INS just to have time to try out an idea and being an entrepreneur. And there are a lot of other cool things, like from AWS, it's a really great funding company here in Austria. There's AWS First, and they're especially dedicating money to help you, after school, making something of your idea and founding your own company, probably what you're doing right now at Junior. So there are a lot of opportunities which really help you to just go out and try something. And that was kind of the thing I would like to leave you. And as my last thing I would like to give you with is one quote, not this one from JFK, but also another from Ken Robinson. He's a really awesome guy. He did this most watched TED talk ever. I don't know, 25 million views, whatever. And he was, at the end of his speech, he ended with this really great quote, which goes like this. We, the older generation, we don't see the future. But you do, because it's your future. So our job of the older generation is to help you learn everything you need that you can build your own future. Not based on our thoughts, but what you think is good for you and for your future. And that's something very important. And because I say, do what you think is right for you. Do what you think is right for your families, for this world, okay? Don't always do what other people tell you. Try to change something on your own, because it's your future, okay? It's not our future from this older generation, it's your future. And you have to live in this world in 40 years, in 50 years, okay? That's when I'm in pension and retired, and probably at the beach in Australia, hopefully, yeah? But you are still at my age, and probably your children. So do whatever you want, do whatever you think is the best, and don't always listen to us. Thank you very much.